Hey guys, welcome back. Alright, let's see what we got here. Got the speed gel, the bouncing gel. Alright. Let's see. Got a cube there. Got a switch there. Well, might as well see what the switch does. Okay, turns that. There's the exit, so I'm guessing we have to get the blue gel on there. And we have to jump from there. Okay. That's where the cube comes in, so let's get the cube first. So we gotta go from there. Let's see. In there. Jump from there. Alright. Well. We're gonna have to run a bit, so drop some of the speed gel over there. And then it looks like we're gonna have to bounce there, so let's see if we can throw it. Yes, we can. Okay, I think that we are all set. So let's just move back here. All right. Ooh. Okay. Anyway, got our cube. Let's shoot a portal over there. Now, how are we gonna get the blue gel on there? All right. Well, let's leave the block right there for now. Okay. Blue gel there. And shoot it onto the top of that. That way, when it turns around, the gel will be there. And it's stuck, so. Pretty sure that's what we have to do. Now, let's go check what's up there. Okay. This red arrow probably means we need speed, and yeah, I'd have to agree with that, so let's get the speed gel there. And just, we're not gonna have enough speed to with just this, so let's actually do this to get that extra bit of speed that we need.
In case you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us.
That actually does sound like a good deal, if you aren't the person going in.
Thank you. I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you had any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want old newspapers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carol and one of these people buy.
Tattered hats, beard dirt.
Yeah. I would be the person who would blow it on a tattered hat. Alright, so I'm guessing we need to go up there. How would I go about doing it?
Carolyn, Carolyn, Carolyn.
Maybe not.
Why do I know this woman? Did I kill her? Or... Oh my god. Look, you're doing a great job. Can you handle things for yourself for a while?
When have we not handled ourselves, but handled things by ourselves? Just saying. And now we're introduced to white gel, which is pretty cool. I do see some stuff. case you're wondering, yes, I have played through the rest of this game by now, so this game is no longer a blind run. Granted, it was a few days ago, so I don't remember everything about it, but I remember enough. Alright, let's wait for these things to close down, and break for it. There we go. My new boss is a robot. Robots are apparently better than us. The game tries to trick you a few times by just randomly requiring you to backtrack. Fortunately, I've already spent hours figuring this out. Alright, and let's go. There we are.
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. The bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. And guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're gonna see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. I might give you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive and do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills.
Okay, so very important thing to notice there, in case you weren't really listening. The white gel is made out of moon rocks. And you'll see why that's important later. And now we are really introduced to the white gel. This can be kind of annoying at times. You have to try to spread the white gel all around the place as much as you possibly can. And I have to try to get it on the outside of there. So that you can... I hate going through two portals that are on the floor. Or really, I guess just an exit portal on the floor. But anyway. Yeah, so... this is a blatantly obvious direction where to go. But... you kind of do have to figure a lot out for yourself here. Basically, just cover this entire bit with the white gel. At least, this is how I did. I don't know if there's another way. I don't know if there's multiple ways to get through this game, but... either way. Yeah, just cover up every bit of it. And then... just try to cover up as high up on this as you can. That's looking all right now. So, do is this. All right. Here, drop a blue portal. Drop another blue portal. Part's a little tricky. I don't know. Like I said before, I don't know if I'm even doing it like how you're supposed to. But you can't argue with the fact that crap, I beat the game, so either way. The motion's a little tricky here, because if you don't have your mouse pointed in exactly the right spot, then you end up just kinda going straight up into the air and you don't gain any momentum. Which is what you need in order to get onto that the ledge there. This is where, learning the trick of, you know, just like, you don't really try to aim for a portal.
Alright, I've been thinking. When life gives you lemons, don't make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life take the lemons back.
Yeah.
Get mad!
Yeah.
I don't want your damn lemons! What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Demand to see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day and thought it could give Cave Johnson lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's gonna burn your house down with the lemons. I'm gonna get my engineers to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down.
Point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence, we should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm gonna say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. Alright, test over. You can head on back to your desk.
Goodbye, sir.
Okay. Like I was saying, something you gotta learn about this game. Early on, or else you'll get very frustrated with it, is you'll notice that I don't shoot this red portal right now. I actually just drop down and wait to see. Well, that was a bad example. And wait to see where I land. And right before I hit the ground, I shoot the portal, because that way you're always accurate with your portal shots. Alright. This one, you really have no choice of where to go. Seriously. There we go. And that was actually the backstory of where GLaDOS came from, if you haven't guessed. If you haven't guessed, well, sorry.